Headers and footers can display things like the page number, date, or company name in the top and bottom margins of your document. Not only do they make those things easier to reference, they also add a nice professional touch. To insert a header, footer, or just page numbering, start by going to Insert, then the Header and Footer group. I'd like to show you how headers work. You can choose one of the blank options at the top, or scroll down for something with a little more style. Notice the Design tab appears along with the header. For now, I'm just going to go ahead and type my information into these boxes, which are called content controls. Most of the built-in headers and footers have them, for things like the name of your company or, in this case, the document title. Now, I don't really need this next field, the one for the author's name, so I'm going to remove it altogether. Just right-click, remove content control, and it's taken care of. When you're done, you can close the header or footer by clicking here. To edit it again, you'll need to unlock that part of your document by double-clicking it like this. I forgot that I wanted to include the date, maybe right here where the other content control used to be. Just click Date and Time, then choose how you want the date to appear. It'll stay at today's date, even if you edit the document again next week, unless you check the box to update it automatically. Let's take a look at page numbers next. The header I chose doesn't have them, but they're really easy to add. First, I need to place my cursor exactly where I want the numbering to go. Now we can go to Page Number to look over the different options. Top of page and bottom of page are tricky. They will add numbering to your document, but in the place of your header or footer. Sometimes that's what you want, but right now I'm just trying to add numbering to the header I have. That's what page margins and current position are for. Current position will put it right where my cursor is, and that looks great. That's exactly where I wanted it. You can even format the page number by going back to Page Number, Format, and choosing a style from the list. There are numbers, letters, and Roman numerals. Here's another trick if you have a cover page like I do, and you don't want any headers, footers, or numbers to appear on it. You can click Different First Page, and the header will disappear from the first page, but start back up on the second. There are still lots of other options, ranging from pictures to position, so take some time to explore the Design tab, try different things, and learn about all the options associated with headers, footers, and numbering.
Like what you just saw?
Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCF LearnFree.org.